Okay, an oil change on a 2000 Camry. Happens to be a station wagon, but the main thing here is it's a 2.2 litre engine. So there's the oil filter, and that's the dipstick. And I do have the passenger side in Australia, which is the left hand side, jacked up so that I've got enough room to get underneath the engine and work. Okay, so working off the premise that if it can happen, it's gonna happen, I've got a backup with my car jack. So that's the deal. Okay, and that's not going to collapse because that's pine sleepers cut, I think it's 250 long lengths. That's millimetres metric. Yes, it's 250 millimetres in length. 1 foot would be better. Okay, so this is my first attempt at changing my oil on my 2000 Camry. Okay, so basically we got a 2.2 four-cylinder engine there, and we've got a gearbox on this side. It's front-wheel drive, and I know that front-wheel drive is very good on the snow because, you know, the back of the vehicle won't spring out everywhere. Also, you've got the weight of the engine over the drive wheels. It makes sense. It's just that the doing any work on the linkages on the front wheel suspension and ball joints is a little more complicated, to say the least. But anyway, generally we've got an oil filter there for the engine. We're going to replace that because we've just got the just purchased the vehicle. We don't know how old the oil is. Incidentally, I change my oil every 5,000 kilometers. I think that's 300 miles. And when I change my motor oil, if I've got an automatic gearbox, I drain the pan. I don't flush it out. I just drain the pan and replace that oil. But anyway, we're going to concentrate on the engine today. And so looking under the car, that there on the end is the that's the drain plug. Why has Toyota put it on the back of the pan there? Probably so that if the bolt is here underneath and it gets struck by a rock or a road speed bump, then it could knock the nut off. That's the automatic. That's the drain for the automatic transmission. Following video will be taking the pan off, replacing the oil filter, because I don't know how old the oil filter is. But anyway, the subject is replacing the engine oil, so that's what we're going to get down to right now. Okay, so the first thing I have to do is find a way to remove this oil filter and stop the oil dripping all the way down the engine here, so I'll see what I come up with for that. Okay, well, I've just got a plastic funnel there. However, it does go down there, so that's not going to work. Okay, so that's the deal, and I'll put that in place now. I also have the wheels chocked. I got the filter to turn with these pliers here. There's limited room there, but I did manage to get it to turn. What you can do is buy a filter with a nut on the end, so you're able to just use a socket and undo it that way. Okay, so I've got my oil gutter there. I've got the oil pan lined up underneath, so I'll remove it now, and that's working pretty well. It's not exactly what I'd call clean oil. It seems to be fairly thick oil. It could be, geez, I don't know, 60 weight oil. Could be 20W50, but that's not very clean. I'll just do it up, you know, about that. That tight should be sufficient. Okay, at this point the nut is back in the drain pan, and I'll get rid of the jack and the blocks. Okay, there seems to be only 3 litres in the oil catch pan there. So I'll put 3 litres in, and then I'll start adding more oil until it's at the right place on the dipstick. Okay, this is 1 litre. You might have to put a piece of cloth behind the funnel, because a bit did spill out. Okay, 2 litres. I'll just tip that in a bit slower. Okay, this is 3 litres. Okay, 3 litres, and it's almost full. Well, that's a surprise. I thought it would take close to 4 litres. Okay, I'll put the cap on and start it up. Okay, after starting, we've got, if it'll focus, about halfway on the line, so it's about up to there, and the full mark is here. Okay, so I've got about half a litre. I'm going to add, I'd say, about 400 mils. So, yep, I'll go ahead and put the rest of the half litre in. So yeah, that's where the oil seems to be, and if it'll focus, then that'll show that that seems to be the right amount of oil, is the 3.5 litres. Okay, that's it, oil change on a year 2000 Camry. A bit of oil did get on here, even with the oil protection thing I built there. So that's just there, and I cleaned it up with a bit of degreaser. Also, just be careful when tipping oil back into the engine. It can drip down behind here, and it sort of lodges in this inlet manifold just around down there. There's nowhere for it to drain, so just be careful of that. And there's the injector there, so anyway, it was fairly painless. It was surprising how thick and how dirty the original engine oil was. It seemed like possibly 60 weight oil. You shouldn't really do this, but I've added 40 weight and 60 weight together, so that gives 50 weight. It is the same manufacturer. I'm pretty sure that I'll be running 50 weight oil in this. However, you see, it doesn't snow here. And if you're in US, and especially Canada, where it does get very cold, then the viscosity, or how thick the oil is very important. And also, in areas like that, you'd want to use synthetic oil. So just use whatever oil is recommended by the manufacturer. So, yeah, with that said, all good. And change your oil every 5,000 kilometres or 3,000 miles. And don't mash down on the accelerator. Just drive with caution. And your engine should last to 500,000 kilometres. Okay? Okay, all good. Please like and subscribe, and over and out. When you get a new vehicle, you can find out how old the oil is or the condition of the engine. And what you don't want to see, I'm not sure if it'll show up there, but that metallic filings, that's not a good sign, so it may show up there. So you just sort of put a bit of fuel in it, swish it around, and when you bring it back, you can might be able to see there the metal filings. But you know, it could be old oil, and it may not have had a proper oil change. See a bit of it there. Okay, well, you know, the hope is that the engine's okay. It's not good for the first oil change. However, the oil did have to be changed. The previous owner didn't have much mechanical knowledge. I know that he was a medium-paced driver. He was neither fast or slow, but yeah, no, there's some type of internal damage. You know, the hope here is that as I change the oil out, at 5,000 kilometer intervals that it eventually cleans up and it's able to carry on. The car is good to drive. It seems to have enough power. It may be down a little bit on power, I'm not sure, but anyway, here's hoping.